This week we're talking about help.
And what it means to have a helping hand. Well, hello everyone and welcome to CAMSA Connect, your weekly worship service from Cambridge Salvation Army here in the UK.
It's good to have you with us, and today we're going to the book of Acts to look at a story about an earthquake and how God gave a helping hand to set free a couple of guys who had been wrongfully imprisoned.
Right. Well, we're still on with the fitting out of our building, and today Norman has big news about when we are coming back to our buildings because we now have a date.
Yay! We have a date, but still no desks. Earlier in the week, this happened. Martin, can you read this paper for me, please?
Not ideal, is it? Far from ideal, but anyway, they're supposed to be coming tomorrow, so stay tuned for exciting desk updates next week.
All right then. Well, today on CAMSA Connect, we've got music from our worship band, a testimony from Bracha, one of our young people, and a children's story from Diane, who from the looks of things has a friend with her today.
Excellent. Well, all welcome on CAMSA Connect, right? And we've got the final batch of photos of CAMSA pins to show you. We've had loads of photos in this week from all around the world, so we can't wait to share them with you. And we've a very special guest who has also decided to wear a CAMSA pin. That's going to be exciting, isn't it? Big announcement for that later on.
Well, let's get our worship underway with a song about how God gives us a helping hand. O God, our help in ages past. Thanks for that good sing, and here's a short prayer you can join in with by saying with us the words as they appear on screen. Dear God, you have been our help in ages past, and we thank you that you help us today too. As we learn about your power and presence today, help us to trust that you will help us no matter our situation. In Jesus' name we ask it. Amen.
And amen. Okay, well, coming up, we've got the weekly update from Norman, our online offering, and a testimony from Bracha, one of our young people, all about God's help.
Before that, though, here's Diane and her friend with a talk for the young and the young at heart. Thanks, Diane.
Hello, everyone. I'm going to talk to you a little bit this morning about feeling alone. But it's not just me here. I have someone with me. Here he is. This is Bouncer, the kangaroo. I was waving to you there this morning. Over the years, Bouncer has helped me a lot with children I've been teaching, and I thought he could help us today. Sometimes you might feel alone. That can be really difficult. You can feel maybe a bit sad or worried. You might feel that nobody is really caring about you. You might not feel confident in dealing with the situation. Vance has got some things in his pouch here, and so we're going to see what a situation where someone might feel alone could be like. Okay, imagine this one then. Bouncer's reading it first. Very good. You break your sister's new toy. What should you do? Now, you might feel alone because maybe you know that you've done something wrong. Maybe you didn't mean to do it, but it has happened. But you feel bad about it. Maybe you did it on purpose because you were really cross. And you feel bad about that too. What should you do? Well, you need to talk to somebody about it, don't you? And then you'll be able to get things sorted out. So there's something you can do in that situation. Let's find another one. Here we are. What about that one, Bouncer? He's having a read. So, one of the children in your new school is having a birthday party. They give out the invitations, but you don't get one. I can see how someone might feel very alone in that situation, knowing that a party was going to be happening, but that they hadn't been invited. What should that person do to feel better in that situation? I think, in many ways, your best person to talk to are your grown-ups at home, who would be able to help you to understand how you're feeling and to feel a bit better about that situation. When you've moved to a new school, it is difficult to make lots of new friends, isn't it? But that's a tricky situation. I could see how someone could feel very alone in that situation. And here's one more. Bouncer, just listen while I read this one, okay? You have just gone to a new school. The teacher asks a girl to look after you, but she leaves you alone in the playground at playtime. That could be very difficult. We can imagine, can't we, how it would feel to be in a new school and you don't know people and you're not sure what you can do and who you can play with. What could you do in that situation? Bouncer, I'm sure Bouncer's got lots of ideas. Perhaps you could talk to someone from your class and say, can I join in your game? Perhaps you could talk to one of the grown-ups that is in the playground and say, I'd like to join in the game, can you help me? But I can understand, again, how that could be very difficult, couldn't it? Feeling alone and not being confident in a situation, maybe not knowing what to do. There are things we can do and people we can talk to. But you know, also, as Christians, in the Bible, it tells us a lot that we are actually never alone, but that we actually have God with us always. God loves us and he cares about us. And we can always talk to him. And in those times when we maybe feel alone, it's especially a good time to talk to him. So the next time that you are feeling alone, remember that God says to us in the Bible, I am with you always. And you know, he will help us in any situation, not just those ones we talked about, but anyone. That's a great thing, isn't it? Have a good day. Goodbye from me and from Bouncer.
Thanks very much to Diane and Bouncer, of course, for that children's story. Actually, I did hear that Bouncer might be looking for a job in a nightclub soon. Well, I thought that was better than the standard woolly jumper joke. Hello, everyone. It's good to have you sharing with us once again. Last week, I asked viewers to let us know how long they have been watching CAMSA Connect, and also to let us know in the video chat or drop us an email. It would be good to hear from you about that, and if you want to add a message, we'd love to hear that too. Maybe you might be aware that we've had a building scheme ongoing. Of course you are. And we are continuing with the fitting out and preparing of our refurbished buildings for our new programmes. I mentioned last week about how material delays have had a massive impact on our project completion. But I have news. Having taken stock of the delays and availability of the materials that we need, I'm pleased to announce that we shall be having our first meeting back in our hall on September the 11th. This will be known as Celebration Sunday. The light at the end of the tunnel is no longer the train coming the other way. Praise the Lord. In the meantime, I would take this opportunity to remind and invite you to share in worship with us in person, whether you live locally or just visiting. Either way, you'll be most welcome to come and join with us at the barracks every Sunday at 10 a.m. If you do come and have a CAMSA pin, then don't forget to wear it. Very soon, our prayer leaflets for June will be published and will be available for everyone. Just let us know if you want one and we can arrange for this to be sent to you either electronically or by post, whichever is your preference. Now, we seem to have had a lot of birthdays at our core this past week. Here's a fact. Did you know that for most people, you actually share your birth date with about 20 million other people in the world? Thought you might be interested. Now, I don't usually talk about birthdays, but as the youngest member in my fan club reached the ripe old age of 11 during the week, I thought he deserved a mention. I hope you had a great birthday, Gideon. Thanks for watching, and now we're going to listen to Gideon's sister, Bracha, as she brings to us her testimony.
Hello, CAMSA Connect. My name is Bracha, and today I'd like to share with you my testimony about how God has helped me during times when I felt alone. During the coronavirus lockdown, I felt very isolated. This led to me experiencing lots of anxiety, and due to this, I ended up reading my Bible really frequently. Whenever I opened my Bible, God would most often open me in 1 Peter 5, verse 7, which reminded me that He cared for me, and that I could trust Him with my anxieties and burdens.
Thank you, Bracha, for that honest take on how God helps you. And thank you, everyone, for participating in the offering each week. It's greatly appreciated, and it helps the Salvation Army in Cambridge make a difference in the lives of others. Thank you very much.
And as always, check out the description below for other ways to give if you don't use a smartphone or the gift app.
That's right. Thanks for your support. Well, our CAMSA pins continue to be sent out in the post, and loads of you have been sending in your pictures. So who have we got in our final round of pictures? Let's see.
We've got Barbara from Cardiff in Wales. Hello, Barbara, and thanks for watching.
We've got Britt from Södertälje Salvation Army in Sweden.
Here is Davinia's mum, Carol, who is on a cruise, mm-hmm. and Davinia's sister, Justin, from Preston, who wears her CAMSA pin on her school lanyard. Well done, both.
Here is Anne and Gavin's dog, Alfie, who's looking very swish with his CAMSA pin.
And Morris and Muriel, looking good, guys. And here's Paul, wearing his at work this week.
Here are Leanne's parents, David and Hilary, over in Northern Ireland, looking good, guys.
And here are two more from the CAMSA clan, Ron and Sylvia, enjoying the sunshine.
Here's Rachel's cousin Stuart with his pal Major Andrew Watkinson over in Ontario, Canada. They're wearing their CAMSA pins whilst enjoying a Tim Hortons coffee. Wow, wouldn't we really like a Tim Hortons coffee?
Yes, and some Timbits. And finally, our very special guest wearing his CAMSA pin today is
Commissioner Anthony Cottrell.
He's the leader of the Salvation Army here in the UK and Ireland Territory. Well done, Commissioner, and thank you.
Yeah, thanks very much. Are we going to have to behave ourselves now that the TC is watching?
Yes. Okay. Yes.
Right then, everyone. So if you haven't yet ordered your CAMSA pin, well, what are you waiting for? It's a great way to make a witness as well as support our building project.
So that's all the photos for now, but please do keep on sending your pictures and perhaps a bit later in the year we will show some more. Thanks again for your support and don't forget to order yours soon.
Okay, well, it's almost time to sing another song before we delve into Acts chapter 16 to see what we can learn.
First though, we're going to go to the passage itself and hear the verses read for us. And to do that today are Richard and then Sylvia, both of whom worship with us at Cambridge Salvation Army.
Acts 16, verse 16 to 34. Paul and Silas in prison. Once when we were going to the place of prayer, we were met by a slave girl who had a spirit by which she predicted the future. She earned a great deal of money for her owners by fortune telling. This girl followed Paul and the rest of us, shouting, "These men are servants of the Most High God, who are telling you the way to be saved." She kept up this for many days. Finally, Paul became so troubled that he turned round and said to the Spirit, "In the name of Jesus Christ, I command you to come out of her." At that moment, the spirit left her. When the owner of the girl's slave realized that their hope of making money was gone, they seized Paul and Silas and dragged them into the marketplace to face the authorities. They brought them before the magistrates and said, "These men are Jews and are throwing our city into an uproar by advocating customs unlawful for us Romans to accept or practice." The crowd joined in the attack against Paul and Silas, and the magistrates ordered them to be stripped and beaten. After they had been severely flogged, they were thrown into prison. And the jailer was commanded to guard them carefully. Upon receiving such orders, he put them in the inner cell and fastened their feet in the stocks.
About midnight, Paul and Silas were praying and singing hymns to God, and the other prisoners were listening to them. Suddenly, there was such a violent earthquake that the foundations of the prison were shaken. At once, all the prisoner doors flew open, and everyone's chains came loose. The jailer woke up, and when he saw the prison doors open, he drew his sword and was about to kill himself because he thought the prisoners had escaped. But Paul shouted, "Don't harm yourself, we are all here." The jailer called for lights, rushed in and fell trembling before Paul and Silas. He then brought them out and asked, "Sirs, what must I do to be saved?" They replied, "Believe in the Lord Jesus, and you will be saved, you and your household." Then they spoke the word of the Lord to him and all the others in his house. At that hour of the night, the jailer took them and washed their wounds. Then immediately he and all his household were baptized. The jailer brought them into his house and set a meal before them. He was filled with joy because he had come to believe in God, he and his whole household. Amen.
So in our story today, Paul and Silas were involved in some amazing events. First of all, there was the incident with the slave girl. An evil spirit had given her the ability to tell fortunes. Her handlers were making lots of money by charging people to hear what the future held. And when she spotted Paul and his companions, she started shouting, "These men are God's slaves. They're telling you how to be saved." At first, this probably seemed like good publicity, but she carried on shouting, "These men are God's slaves. They're telling you how to be saved." And she carried on for days. In the end, Paul shouted to the evil spirit, "I order you in the name of Jesus Christ to come out of her." And straight away, the spirit left her in peace. Well, that was when the trouble started, of course. The slave girl's handlers had lost their money-making scheme, so they were furious. They grabbed Paul and his colleague Silas and dragged them in front of the magistrates. They accused them of disturbing the peace. An angry mob gathered there and there were outbreaks of violence. The magistrates ordered that Paul and Silas should be severely beaten. Then they were dragged off to prison in chains. We read that the jailer locked them in this maximum security cell and fastened their feet in stocks. At about midnight, they began singing and praying, and other prisoners started to join in too. And shortly after midnight, an earthquake struck. The tremor broke open all the prison doors and shook loose everyone's chains. When the jailer came to and saw that every cell was open, he jumped to the obvious conclusion that all of his prisoners had escaped, but in fact, every one of them was still there. He would have been amazed because he fell to his knees, we read, in front of Paul and Silas and asked, "Sirs, how might I be saved?" Paul replied with, "Well, simply believe in Jesus and you will be saved, you and your whole family." So in the small hours of that morning, the jailer welcomed Paul and Silas into his own home. He cleaned their wounds and he fed them, and then they baptized his whole family. It would have been dawn and the celebrations would still have been in full swing, I'm sure. So they got rid of a slave girl's evil spirit, an earthquake broke open their prison doors, but they didn't run away, and they converted the jailer and baptised his family. Not a bad day's work. What great achievements. Paul and Silas seem almost like superheroes who tackle evil spirits, burst open locked doors, and even change the mind of their enemy. So how did they manage to do all of this? Well, they achieved great things, but they weren't working by themselves. God helped them, and God's power worked through them. Paul got rid of the girl's evil spirit by calling on the name of Jesus Christ. Paul and Silas didn't organise the prison break. They prayed, and the miraculous earthquake broke open their prison doors. Although escape wasn't the point, and of course they didn't run away. Instead, we read that they stayed to convert the awestruck jailer and his family. They baptised them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. And all these events show that neither Paul nor Silas was in fact a superhero with his own superpowers. They were simply faithful followers of Jesus who did his work of healing and making disciples. And they did all this with God's help. Our story reminds us that we can't always manage by ourselves. We need God's help. But it also reminds us that all of us can play a part in helping people with their challenges. Just as God gave a helping hand in this story, so we should too. God helped Paul and Silas break out of their prison, and we can help people break out of the prison of their situation, whatever that may be. So today, let's remember that whenever we can't manage by ourselves, whenever we need God's help, all we have to do is ask. Make sure you ask God for his help today.
Please join us in a prayer. We thank you and praise you, O God, that your help is available to every single person in the world, even in the most difficult situations. We pray that just as you helped Paul and Silas break out of prison in Rome, you will show us how to help people break out of the prison of their circumstances, whatever they might be.
Almighty God, please send us out into the world to represent you by giving a helping hand, strong in the strength of your power. Amen.
And amen. Well, thank you for sharing with us once again, everyone. It's been great to have you along. We'll be back next week for a special Pentecost Sunday episode that includes a new vocal solo from Charlie and music from our songsters.
In the meantime, do leave us a comment to tell us where you're from. And of course, click like here on YouTube if you've appreciated this video. And don't forget to subscribe to stay up to date with all our content too.
So let's conclude our worship today with a song that reminds us of the great things God has done. Until next time, everyone, keep safe, keep well,
and keep connected. God bless you.